like I said, there has to be some sort of monitoring so that gun violence doesn't enter Goa. I think this is the last step that we will face. I have warned this actually many times, specifically with regard to casinos, that with the type of black money and the criminals that come to deal with that black money in the casinos, we will see an increase in crime. And I think the government should investigate whether this murder also was related to casinos, and as well keep a special watch on casinos to make sure that that sort of criminal activity does not spill over into the streets of Panjim.
But asking for the white paper, but as an Aam Aadmi Party, will you file some RTO or something to the police department asking for the how many legal license are there?
Definitely, I think this information needs to be made public now, so we'll definitely file an RTI on this. And I think, you know, RTI is something that is should be a last step. But the government, when the crime rates are rising, when such incidents are happening, should by itself take such action and announce to the public that they're taking such action. Because in the end, the people should feel safe and the people should have some sort of feeling of reassurance that the government is doing something for their safety.
As to any illegal guns are there in Goa?
I'm definitely sure there must be some illegal guns, and I think the only way to find out is to locate and monitor the legal guns. Then whatever is left is legal. So I think anybody found in possession of guns that are not registered and not monitored by the government should be considered illegal, and they should be confiscated and action should be taken against the person.
What did you say when you talk about this such incidents at the same time, like one is in south and one is in north? How serious you are looking on these issues?
No, I think this basically shows one simple thing, that the criminals are not afraid of any consequences of their actions. This is a simple lesson that everybody can take from these incidents, where in broad daylight, somebody is murdered, somebody is assaulted, somebody is shot dead. I think this basically means that there is no law and order, or like in UP and all the places where, you know, we have seen that sometimes the law, some element from the law and order system themselves are in cahoots and in league with these criminals for various reasons. So I think if that is the case, then that I think is a really, really even more sad and unfortunate turn of events, where not only are criminals giving themselves a free hand, but they have corrupted our law and order system to such an extent that now our law and order system is compromised to such criminals.